A very good day to all of you. You have all learnt the basic part of writer 1 and 2. Today, you will learn about a new part of Open Office. You will now be learning about Impress, presentation. You will be using Impress or presentation in the same way as you have learned to do in Writer. Impress or presentation is an important part of Open Office. It will be very useful for you to learn Impress. With the help of Impress, you can present your school projects, your office work in a very effective manner. Let us start learning Impress presentation. Switch on your computer. And let us now begin today's class. Today, you will learn the following about Impress, PowerPoint. What is Impress? Why do we use Impress? How do we open an Impress file? How do we work with the Impress file? What are slides? What is a slide pane? What do we mean by slide layout? What is the drawing bar? What are the line and filling toolbars? How do you draw a line? And within that, how do we change the design with the help of formatting? And how can you write text within the Impress file? You will also learn about its home page, like what is slide layout, slide design. Can you tell what is Impress or presentation? Impress is a software which helps you to show your documents as slides. You can use different designs for your documents and show graphics within them to present them to your users. Can you tell why we use Impress or PowerPoint in OpenOffice? Impress of OpenOffice is like PowerPoint of MS Office. This helps you to present your project in a better way. Impress has multimedia tools like sound, graphics, animation, which help in making your project more presentable. This can be used in the office to make presentations. Let us now learn how we can open OpenOffice Impress. If you are using Windows XP, Windows 7, Windows 8 or Windows 10, then the method to open an Impress file is different for each. However, for Windows XP and Windows 7, the method to open an Impress file is the same. In case you are using Windows 8 or Windows 10, then you should watch the video for that and learn from the same. Let us now learn how to open Impress file in Windows XP and Windows 7. We can open the Impress PowerPoint file in the same way as we had opened the Writer file. Can you tell in how many ways we can open the Impress file? The Impress file can be opened in three ways. Stepwise, using the shortcut icons on the desktop with the use of the shortcut command. Similarly, you can open the Impress PowerPoint file also in three ways. Stepwise, using the shortcut icons of the desktop with the use of the shortcut command. Let us watch the video and learn the stepwise method to open the Impress file. With the help of this video, we will now learn how to open our Impress file using the stepwise method. For this, you need to first take your pointer to the Start button, which is on the left lower side of your screen. Left click on that with your mouse or touchpad, and then click on the All Programs option. As is being shown in the video, when you click there, all the programs appear in a box. Look for OpenOffice 4.1.1. You can scroll up and down, and when you find this OpenOffice, left click on that, and you will see many options within the OpenOffice opening up. Since we want to open the Impress file, click on the Impress option and a box opens. Now in this box, you see that you can opt for three types of presentations. Empty presentation, as is being shown in the preview, or if you opt for From Template, then you will be offered to open the presentations which are pre-existing as templates. So as you can see in the preview, you can click on the one which you like and then click on Create to open that. If you choose the third option of open an existing presentation, then if you already have a presentation on your computer, you can click on the Open button and it will open that. Since we want a blank presentation, we will click on Empty presentation and click on the Create button, and you will see that your Impress file opens. The picture being shown to you is of Impress. With the help of this picture, let us learn more about Impress. Can you tell what is the title bar? The title bar shows the saved file's name and the name of the application. Can you tell what is a standard toolbar? With the help of the standard toolbar, you can get your work done quickly and easily, since the standard toolbar contains some options of all menus and can be used like shortcuts. Now, look at the picture in front of you. This is the line and filling toolbar. Can you tell why we use line and filling? By using line and filling toolbar, you can format any clip art or picture's line and the color inside it. Look at the picture being shown to you. This is called the slide pane or slide bar. The slide bar shows the slides on which you are currently working. Let us now watch the video and learn how we can show or hide the slide bar, and also how we can increase or decrease the box size of the slide bar. With the help of this video, we will learn how we can hide or show the slide pane or the slide bar. On the left of your slide, where you see small images of the slide, this is the slide pane, as is being shown in the video. And if you want to hide this, you can see there are some dots on this area, as is being shown in the video. When you bring your cursor there, it shows written hide. So if you click there, left click on that, the slide pane gets hidden. Now, if you want to show them again, You see on the extreme left, there are dots. Click on that with the cursor. It says show and the slide pane will show again. Now, if you want to increase or decrease the size of the slide bar, bring your cursor here. When you see these double head arrows, you can left click on the cursor and drag it towards the right. And the slide bar or the slide pane, the size increases. If you want to decrease it, again keep your pointer on this point. When the double head arrows show, keep the left button pressed and then drag towards the left so that the slide bar reduces in size. Look at this picture in front of you. This is called slide layout or slide design, and this helps you to change the type of slide or the style of the slide. With the help of this video, let us learn more about the various designs and also know when we use a particular layout. This video teaches us about how we can hide or show the slide layout and what are the different options in the slide layout. So the slide layout is the layout which is on the right side of the main slide. If you want to hide it, click on the dots and which says hide and the slide layout gets hidden. If you want to show it, click again on the with the left button where it says show and you can see it. You can drag the cursor by keeping it here towards the right side and the slide layout pane becomes smaller. If you drag it towards the left side, the slide layout pane becomes larger. Now, different types of layouts. The first layout is the blank slide. So if you use this, you get a blank slide and you can key in text or drawings, whichever you like. The next is the title slide. So the title slide allows you to add a title and below you can add the text of your choice. The next layout in the slide layout is of the title content. So it gives you an option to give a title and then below you can add content. The content, as you can see, can be a table or a chart, as is being shown in the video to you. It could be a table or a chart or a picture or even a movie slide. The next slide is for title and two contents. So here you add a title and you can add two different contents on the left and the right side of the slide. So you can add two tables or two charts if you like and insert audio visuals like movies and songs and also pictures. The next layout is for title only. So here it allows you to add any title, and if you want to add a picture or a text, you can do so by coming to the area below the title. The next is centered text. So this layout will, whatever you type, will be centered within the slide. So you can click and add the text that you type and it gets centered in the slide. The next layout is for title to content. So here you see you can add a title, and on the left side you have two contents, one above the other, and on the right side you have another area where you can add another content. So actually there are three contents that you can add in this slide layout. The next one is title content and two contents. So again here you can add a title, and now on the right side you have two contents, one above the other, and on the left side you have the main content slide or the area. So this way you can add three different contents here. The next is title to content over content. So here the top two are on the side of each other, the two contents, and below is another content that you can add. So again, you can use different charts or tables or pictures or songs and movies that you want to add in these three areas. The next one is title content over content. So here it divides the slide area into two halves, top and bottom, and you can add two different contents in this slide layout. The next one gives you title and four content possibility. So now, as the name suggests, you can add a title and you can add four contents in the slide area. And the last option here is for title and six contents. So similarly, in this slide, you can add a title and six different contents, which can all be tables or charts or pictures and movies and songs. So if you want to use a title slide, you click on title. If you want to click on the blank slide, you will get a blank slide to use. Next, look at the pictures being shown. You are being shown some views of the presentation file. In Impress, these views can be of five types: normal, outline, notes, handout, and slide sorter. With the help of these views, you can look at your presentation file. Let us watch in the video what happens with the use of these options. With this layout, we will see what options are there for the slide view. So as you know, the slide view can be normal, outline, notes, handout, or slide sorter. So if you click on the normal option here with your left button of the mouse or the touchpad, you see the normal view, which is the normal slide view that you use. If you click on outline, since there are two slides in our slideshow, so you will see these two slides in an outline mode. Next, if you click on the notes option, you have the slide on top and you can add any notes that you want to use below. The next option is the handout option. So in this option, all the slides appear in a handout mode and you can use this. The next option is the slide sorter view. If you take your button cursor there and click, you see the two slides in the slide sorter view. So these are different views of your slide in slide view. So you can click on normal and get the slide back into normal to use. Can you tell why we use drawing tool? With the help of the drawing toolbar, you can make drawings, oval, rectangle, star, etc. Can you tell what is the status bar? In Impress, the status bar tells you about your slides. For example, how many slides are there in your presentation and on which slide you are working upon. You can also make use of the zoom box. Note that while you have pages in a writer file, you have slides in an Impress file. Let us now learn how in Impress we can change any slide to a blank slide and how do we type in it. Can you tell why we use the text tool? With the help of the text tool, you can type in any slide within a box. Now, all of you type your name with the help of the text tool. If you face any problem in doing this, watch the video and learn. In this video, we will learn how we can change any slide to a blank slide. For instance, the slide that you see is a title slide. If you click in the title area, you will see that this area becomes blank and you can type the title. And on the right side, you get the text toolbar. So you can make any changes, type the text. So this video is also showing us how we can use the text toolbar to type text in our slides. Now, if we click on the side, it will again change back to the original form. And now if we click on the blank slide option in the slide layout, this slide changes to a blank slide. So this is how you can get a blank slide. Now you can go and click on the text option on the bottom of the screen and you will be able to type text in your slide. When you bring the cursor here and drag it, you see that a small box appears on the slide. And on the right side of the slide, you see that the text toolbar appears. Now you can type, for instance, we are typing, my name is Rohit. So this is how you can use the text tool to type here. If you want you to type another line, you can again click on the text tool and click in the slide, a box opens and once you start typing, it appears within the box. The text appears within that box. And again on the right side, you can see all the text formatting tools available to you. So you can use them. If you click here, the box disappears and the slide remains with the text that you have typed. Now, if you want to continue on the first line, you can bring the cursor here next to the line at the end of the line and then click with the left button of the mouse or the touchpad. Once again, the box appears and now you can start typing again or you can press enter so that a new line appears within the box and then you can type here. For instance, if you want to type another line here, you will press enter and type, I am 8 years old. So this way, you can add to any existing text on your slide. Similarly, if you want to type on the second line, you can bring the cursor at the end of the second line. Left click on it, the box appears again and on the right side you see the text formatting toolbar available. Again, if you press enter, you will have a new line space within the box and again you can type some additional text. Once again, let's type, I am 8 years old. And then if you click on the outside, the box disappears and the text remains in the slide that you wanted. So this is how you can convert any slide to a blank slide and use the text tool to type within the slide. Let us now learn how we bring up a new slide. In order to bring up a new slide, you should take the pointer with the help of the mouse or touchpad into the slide that you are working on and click with the right button of the mouse or touchpad. A box will open there and you need to select the option for new slide. A new slide will open and using the method taught to you, you can change this slide into a blank slide. Now, go ahead and type about yourself and about your school in the second slide. We will end today's class here. So, go ahead and close your file, and in case of any problem, watch the video and learn from the same. Next, properly shut down your computer. In today's class, you all learned about Impress. You learned what is Impress or PowerPoint and why we use it. You learned what is line and filling toolbar and what is slide pane, what is slide layout and layout bar. In the end, you also learned about using the text tool. Thank you.